my last video, I showed a small teaser of this lean-to that I built to work on my motorcycle, but it's been half completed for half a year now. I've just had the roof decking covered with underlayment and not actually shingled. So, now that we're getting serious about working in here, it's time to finish the roof and the back of the garage. To start off with, we're using some 90 weight, which is normally used for valleys, to connect between the garage and the lean-to roof. Florida code technically requires two layers of this in valleys, however, this is a shed essentially, and I ran out. So we're just gonna do one layer. This first video is going to be the super long version that I won't be speeding up, so you can get an idea of the actual time and length it takes to do all of this. I'll release a supercut later of a condensed and sped up version, and we'll also have that version available for channel members and Patreon members until it gets released to everyone later. There are a couple of time lapses in here though, as that's just how I recorded them, so enjoy those, I guess. The neat thing about 90 weight is that it's actually adhesive backed, so you can lay it down where it needs to go and it will stick to where it's going to be. Unless, of course, the 90 weight you're using is over a year old and the adhesive has begun to fail. If that's the case for you, you'll need to use some roofing tacks as you go. Normally you'd just put one in each corner, lay down your second layer, then add them every 18 inches or so, making sure to stay away from your valley or angled area, not having any roofing tacks within 6 inches of either side of the valley. Once you have the 90 weight tacked in, go ahead and trim your corner so it's not falling over the side of the roof. Ideally, if you have to laminate two pieces together, you want around a 6-inch overlap between them. I ran out of 90 weight, so I was only able to get around a 3-inch overlap here, but again, it's a shed, it's fine. When it comes to shingling your roof, you have starter shingles to start the process. You can also use three-type shingles backwards, but code doesn't actually allow for that, so do with that as you will. Here in Florida, you're required to put down roofing tar before you put your starter shingles down, as it helps prevent lift during high winds, aka, you know, hurricanes, those things we have here. When it comes to applying the roofing tar, you can use a paintbrush, a stick, a putty knife like I am, or your hands, I guess. I probably wouldn't do the hand. It's kind of gross, but you do you, boo-boo. You're aiming to apply the tar about 4 inches wide and about 1 inch away from the end of the roof line. When you apply your starter shingles and nail them down, it'll actually squeeze the tar out a bit, hence why we leave that inch from the edge so you don't end up squeezing tar out onto the ground. Next, we need to put our starter shingles down. They have a nailing edge at the top and on the bottom a tar strip. The tar strip goes down towards the edge of the roof for further adhesion. Making sure the nailing edge is facing up, go ahead and place your starter strips down on the roof, allowing approximately half of an inch of the starter shingle to be hanging off the edge. I usually eyeball it to go with the front edge of the nailing strip, as this puts the tar strip right at the very edge of the roof line. As I mentioned earlier, there will be a sped up version of this video coming out soon to everyone that subscribes to the channel, but will be available same day for channel members and Patreon supporters over there. I know some people really love the longer form content and seeing the full process in its agonizingly slow detail, and others just want the video to be straight to the point and only show off the important parts. When it comes to nailing shingles on, Florida code now requires 6 nails to be put in per shingle. And yes, I'm aware I only did 5 in that starter. I failed at counting. I went back later and put a 6th in, don't worry. I'm sure professional roofers are much quicker and more efficient at this than I am, but my method for making sure I don't need to tar the nails in between shingles is to nail the edges of a row, then come back with my next line of shingles and place them above the prior line so I can see where the edges line up and nail my first row. This guarantees I don't end up with a nail either between two shingles or within an inch of the seams. With architectural shingles, which is what I'm using here, you can stagger your shingles with as little as 6 inches between rows. I end up doing a 1/3 offset for the most part here to avoid wasting as much material as possible. As long as the starting and ending shingles is at least 6 inches long, and the overlap for shingles between two rows is at least 6 inches from the end of the prior row shingle, you're fine.
Thank you.
onto the final row. We need to end the shingles, so we're going to cut right above the nailing strip, so we're still nailing between two shingles, and put that on as our last shingle. Also, whenever you're cutting anything on top of your roof, have a board or piece of plywood down so you're not cutting your brand new shingles or your underlayment. Once you have your last row of shingles down, you'll want to cover the exposed nails with your roofing tar. This ensures that no water will be able to seep in through those exposed nail holes. Now we're going to finish up the last bit of the top row, which requires cutting a bunch of shingles and nailing them down. There will be another couple of videos coming out for this little roofing project, including the ideal way to finish off your roof and tie it into the existing structure. There are a few different ways to do it, and if you already have all of your siding on, you are limited a bit, but I'll discuss those more when that video comes out. As always, if you like the content I'm putting out, make sure to like, comment, share, subscribe, and don't forget to hit the notification bell to stay up to date with all new content as it comes out. That's all for today's rather lengthy video, but I hope you enjoyed it and that it was informative for you. Thanks so much for tuning in, and have a wonderful day. Bye for now.